Good morning, all of you. We are going to study chapter 9, algebraic expression and identity. In this chapter, we are going to study about what is variable, what are constant, what are expression, equations, what are the basic terms used in algebraic expressions, how to find out the factors, what is known as coefficient, monomial, binomial, trinomial, polynomial, and the basic identities which we are going to use in this algebraic expression. And the last, like and unlike term. So we will start one by one. We will discuss all these points in this introduction video, so that these, if you understand these terms, this chapter will be very easy for all of you. So one by one we will go on discussing these points. So the very first here is, what is variable? What is variable? Variable is means anything or number which can be changed. Means variable means it can be goes on changing. Suppose if I write 2x plus 1, okay, if I write here 2x plus 1, here the value of x, it can be changed, it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever, okay. So for here, variable means what? X. From here I can write down variable here is x. So 2x plus 1 is an expression, and what is the variable here? X is the variable here. Similarly, if I write 5x square plus 2y plus 1, okay, from here this expression, this x can also be changed and this y can be changed. Means in this expression, x and y both are variables. So here, what is variable? 2x from this expression, x is the variable. Here 5x square plus 2y, here x and y both are variable. If I write here x plus y plus z equal to 0, this is an equation. Here x, y and z, they are what? They are variable. It can be changed, it can be any of the number, any digits, alphabets we are using to represent the variable, and it can be changed. It can be x, y, z, it can be u, t, r, s, p, q, r, s, anything. So here you understand what is variable. X, y, z is the variable here. Similarly, we will study about what is constant. Here the second point is variable, you have understand. X, y, z, all these are variables. Constant. Now second point is what? Constant. Constant means it has a fixed value and it cannot be changed. It has a fixed value and it cannot be changed. Suppose if I am writing 2x plus 5, here you know this x is what? Variable. But what is 2? Is the value of 2 going to change? Is the value 5 going to change? No. So what are constants which are not going to change? Means this 5 and this 2, this will not be changed. So these 5 and 2 in this expression is the constant here, whose value does not change. In your variable, whose value can be changed. Okay. Similarly, for the constant, whose value cannot be changed. In variable, the value can be changed. In constant, the value cannot be changed. Now, what is the third one? Third one is the expression. Third one is the expression. Now what is expression here? So if I write 2x plus 5, 3y plus 2, 4z minus 1, these all are expression. Here what we use, here we use a combination of alphabets plus number. The combination of, or I can say the combinations of constant and variable, they form an expression. And this identities, plus minus division, these are added. Okay, so what is expression? If I write 2x plus 5, this is an expression because here I am getting variable constant also. This 2 is constant, this 5 is constant, and here x is the variable. So what is an expression? Is formed with the combination of constant as well as variable. Similarly, if I write 3y plus 2, this is a, here y is variable and 3 and 2 are the constant. Similarly, if I write 4z minus 1, this is also an expression because 4 and 1, it is not going to change, therefore it is constant, and the value of it, value of z, it can be changed, therefore this is a variable. So very most and important point here, that is, what is the difference between expression and equation? If I write 4x plus 5, this is an expression. Okay, now we are going to study equation. What does an equation mean? Equation means, if I write here, same example I am taking, 4x plus 5, this is an expression because here variable is also present and consonant is also present. But if I write 4x plus 5 equal to 7, suppose if I write 4x plus 5 equal to 7, then this will become a equation. This will form a equation because here equal to sign is there. Because here equal to sign is there. If I write it as just 4x plus 5, then this is not an equation, this is an expression. But if I write equal to sign with this expression, then this will become a equation. Okay, and in an equation you have two sides, that is left hand side and right hand side. So this is equal to sign on the left hand, this is left hand side equation, and on the right hand, that is right hand side equation. So LHS means left hand side and RHS means right hand side. Now the next topic is terms. Terms. What is terms here? If I write 5x, or if I write 5yz, or if I write 5x plus 2y and 2x plus 1y plus z, okay? Here it is containing 5x is a single term, means one term. Here you are having this 5x and this 2y. These are two terms. If I write 2x plus 1y plus z, here nothing is there, that means one is there. Okay, so this is one term, two term and three term, and similarly it will go on. So these are terms. Now what is this factors? What are these factors? Next topic is factors. This is factors. Suppose I write 4x and I wanted to find out the factor of 4x, so I can write down this as 4 and x. So 4 and x are the factors of 4x. Suppose if I want to write 5xy, what are the factors of these terms? The terms here, it is having one term, that is 5, x and y are the factors. Understood what I am going to say? The factors of 4x are 4 and x. The factor of 5xy are 5 x and y. Similarly, if I will add one z here, this will be 5xyz. The factor of 5xy are 5xyz. Similarly, you are going to study about the coefficient. This is done, this is done, this is done. Now we are going to study about the coefficient. What is coefficient here? If I write 12x, 4y, 14y plus 12z. Okay, so what is coefficient here? Here I am having x and the number which is multiplied with the variable, that is 12. So if I say what is the coefficient of x, you will say 12 is the coefficient of x. Similarly, if I say what is the coefficient of y, so here you know 14 is multiplied by y, so what is the coefficient of y? 14 is the coefficient of y. Now again, if I say what is the coefficient of z, you will say, madam, 12 is the coefficient of z. So understood what do you mean by coefficient? Now we are going to study about monomial, binomial and trinomial. So what is monomial? I am starting with the first one, monomial. Here the term mono means what? Mono means one. So monomial it will contain how many terms? One term. In monomial it will contain only one term. Okay. In monomial it will contain only one term, that is, if I write example 5x, 2x, 4y, 2z, 1x, these are monomials because here it is containing only one term, then this is known as what? Monomial. Second one is binomial. Bi means two. Okay, so from here you know that here from mono means one variable, one term. So bio means two, means how many terms will be present here? Two terms will be present here. Suppose if I write 2xy, so how many terms are present here? Two terms are present here. Kya kya? Binomial means two, monomial means one. Means here only one terms will be present. In binomial, two terms will be present. Suppose if I write 2x plus 1, that means how many terms are there? This 2x is one term and this one is another term. How many terms are there? That means two terms are there. So this is a binomial. If I write 5x square plus 2, so how many terms are there? Two terms are there. So this is a binomial. Similarly, if I write trinomial means, tri means how much? Three. Means how many terms will be there? Three terms will be there. Suppose I write 10x square plus 4x plus 1. So this is a trinomial because here three terms are there, that is 10x square, 4x and 1. These are three terms. So this will come under the category of trinomial. Now what is polynomial? Madam, if monomial is 1, binomial is 2, 3, trinomial is 3 and so polynomial will be 4. No, it is not like that. Polynomial means it can contain n numbers of terms. Suppose if I write 4x to the power 4 plus 2x to the power 3 plus 1x to the power 2 plus 5. So here how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4, or I can write down this as x. So this is a polynomial, and if I can exceed this as plus, suppose I write it 1, so then also this is a polynomial. Okay, so for this you can write down monomial, binomial, trinomial. Here the term is, in monomial it is 1, and binomial 2, and trinomial 3, but in polynomial you can take it as it can exceed more than 3. Now what is identities? Identities, this will be very useful to you while solving the algebraic expressions. Now what are identities here? Identities means, this is a formula. Suppose I am writing identities A plus B whole square. You have to learn this by heart, because this, using this identities only you are going to solve the expression and question. Suppose you are given with A plus B square. So the formula for A plus B square is A square plus B square plus 2AB. This is the formula plus for A plus B square. Okay. Similarly, for A minus B whole square, what you will write down for A minus B whole square is A square plus B square, and here minus will come. So this is minus 2AB. Here in addition, all are addition, but here in subtraction, A square, here it is plus, but at when you subtract you will get minus 2AB. So A square plus B square minus 2AB is the formula for A minus B whole square. Similarly, you are given with A plus B, A minus B. So this will be equal to A square minus B square. These three identities are very useful. So learn it by heart. Now we are going to start likes and unlike terms. Like and unlike terms. Like and unlike terms mean, suppose I am suppose here I am writing 5x plus 2x square plus 5x 2x square 2x 4x 7x. Okay, here you can see, as here you are having only one variable, that is x, and all the terms you are having only x. Here no y, no z, nothing is there. So these terms are known as what? Like terms. These terms are known as what? Like terms. If I add here 4y plus 5z, 7xy or 7yz. Okay. So here all are added, means xy is also z, zy is also there, z is also there, y is also there, then these are referred as unlike terms. Like and unlike term will be used when you do, it will be used in this chapter, like when you do addition, subtraction. You cannot add, like suppose it is given 5x and you have to add 4y. So you will not be able to x if you are having unlike terms. You can only add if you are given with likes term. Means suppose here it is given 5x and here it is given 4y. So these are unlike terms. You cannot add or subtract this. But if I write here as 4x, now you can easily add this. These are likes term, then you will be able to add or subtract this like term. And in unlike likes term, you cannot add or subtract. So this was the introduction of chapter 9, algebraic expression and identities. We have studied about variable, constant, expression, equation, terms, what are factor, coefficient, monomial, binomial, binomial and polynomial. We use the basic identities which will be useful while solving this chapter, what are likes and what are unlike terms. So go through this video and prepare your notes for today. Thank you.